Hey everyone, it's Mike Ball from WordPress.com. Today we're going to dive in and look at site stats. I get really excited about this stuff. I have a kind of marketing slash optimization background for websites and doing a lot of this and kind of helping people that I've worked with achieve their different goals. So I get really excited when I could see how many people are coming to a site and what they're doing. And this can kind of inform you as well in terms of like, are your strategies working? Are people enjoying the content that you're writing? Which content is performing best? Can you create more of that content? So right now, I went to WordPress.com and I went ahead and selected the Han Solo Project site. Since that one's, it's a live site for my band, which is not very popular, so the stats are going to be a little embarrassing, but it's at least a live site that exists in the wild and should have some numbers on it. So on the left-hand sidebar, if I go down here, you'll see that there's a section dedicated for stats. And these stats are built into Jetpack, which is a tool or platform that we own and have integrated into our product. You might use other analytics tools as well, but these are kind of built in to track on the product from day one. So when you launch your site, you have them ready to go and you can always go back and kind of compare. All the different analytics tools do track differently. So sometimes your numbers might line up and there's articles about out there about why that is, but this is a good reference that's kind of built in. So if we go through here, we have, you can see that it's set to traffic. There's also an insights option. And then over here is the kind of time frame you're looking at. So right now it's looking day by day. I might want to look at weeks or months and we'll see what kind of info we have in there. And so you can see June is when I move the site over to WordPress.com and that's when my stats kind of start. If I go back to weeks, I can get kind of a full view. So we'll check that out. Right now it has this week selected for April 25th and it's telling me one view, one visitor, which is kind of embarrassing, but we haven't put any new music out for a while, so that's on us. Now if we go down a little bit, you're gonna get that breakdown. Now WordPress.com has likes and comments built in, so that'll be tracked as well. And then you're gonna get more insights on the types of content you have in here. So this has posts and pages. It'll tell you which pages are getting any kind of activity. It'll tell you if people are coming from search and what they search for to get there. It'll tell you if any sites are sending traffic your way. And then it'll also tell you where in the world people are coming from. If you switch over to insights, you'll kind of get some different kind of information that you can use to inform, again, your strategy or your content. So this is kind of like a heat map for when I'm getting views based on months. You can average per day. You can kind of look at that breakdown over time. I haven't published any new content. We haven't put out any new music for a while, so that's what this is telling me. I probably should have done that. And then you get a nice breakdown of all your content across your site and kind of your historical views and visitors. So views are when somebody just comes to your site and sees a page. Visitors are, as far as we can tell, different people. So one person might come back to your site 100 times. So you could have 100 views, but only one visitor. This is pretty distributed. So I know that there's a good amount of people coming and they're not always coming back, but a few of them have come several times. Don't have a ton of followers on WordPress.com, but it has social follows integrated, which is kind of cool. And then you can see down here, I have this publicized service, which is basically a marketing tool we have set up in the platform, set up with a Facebook account and the page for this project or whatever. So like I said, you can come in here, you can get general ideas about your traffic, where they're coming from, what your top content is, even what your top authors are if you have multiple authors. If you have videos uploaded and things like that, you can get some basic stats as well. So that's really cool stuff that you can kind of learn to just check every now and then and go back and see if there's anything that stands out, right? Like I might go back to March 31st here and see why I got more views or visits that specific day. I think we had a launch for full site editing around that time and maybe I used this site for some of the demo content. So it's probably mostly people at Automatic, but hopefully we'll get some new music soon and we'll see these stats go up. If you have any questions about different stats or metrics that you look at or what you could look at, go ahead and drop them in the comments. We'll get back to you. Like I said, I really nerd out about this stuff and have done some more complicated analytics tracking kind of implementations to really get insights on what's happening on your site. So happy to talk that through.